गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
कंप्लीटेड द होमवर्क मैम।
ऑल राइट। या एनी डाउट्स विद द होमवर्क?
यस मैम, मी आल्सो कंप्लीटेड।
नो डाउट मैम।
ऑल राइट। ऑल राइट चिल्ड्रन। या so see this question, Ashish studies for 4 hours, 5 hours and 3 hours respectively on three consecutive days, meaning 3 days one after the other, like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, or Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, 3 days one after the other. Ashish studies for 4 hours, 5 hours and 3 hours respectively on three consecutive days. 3 days, one after the other, maybe Friday, Saturday, Sunday, like that.
How many hours? Like 1 day is 4 hours and 1 day 5 hours.
Yeah, so say he studied on Friday, he studies for 4 hours. On Saturday, he studies for 5 hours. And on Sunday, for 3 hours. How many hours does he study daily on an average? So for this, we have to find the mean. See here, they've not mentioned whether you have to find mean, median, or mode. So when you have to find the number of hours he studies on an average, daily on an average, you have to find the mean. How do we find mean?
Ma'am, we should add all the three numbers and divide with three, ma'am.
Divide by three. Okay, children, fine. You can work this later, take a picture. So average study time is the total number of study hours, 4 plus 5 plus 3 divided by the number of days for which he studied. Add all the three numbers and divide by 3. So on an average, he studied for 4 hours per day. On an average, he studied for 4 hours per day. Take a picture, children.
Took a picture, ma'am.
Yeah. A batsman scored the following number of runs in 6 innings, 6 matches, right? A batsman scored the following number of runs in 6 matches, in 6 matches. So in the first match, he scored 36 runs. Second match, 35 runs. Third match, he got 50 runs. Fourth match, 46 runs. Fifth match, 60 runs, and the sixth match, 55 runs. You have to calculate the mean runs scored by him in an inning. Now, see, when he wants to share, share the runs scored by him. Suppose he's played 25 matches. He can't keep listing, no, 25, score he has got in 25 matches, he cannot list. So he will find the average and he'll tell his friends that on an average, I've got, you know, say 40 runs or 40, I've scored 40 in an inning. If he has played 25 matches, then there'll be 25 different scores. Now here he's played only 6 matches, but if he has played 25 matches, there will be 25 different scores. Now, when he's talking to his friends or if he wants to share his score with his people, okay, he can say the scores in the 25 different matches, but if he wants to give one number, he'll find the average, add all the scores, divide by 25, add the 25 scores and divide by 25. So supposing you get 40, then he can easily say, on an average, I've scored 40 runs in an inning. On an average, I have scored 40 runs in a match. On an average, roughly I've scored 40 runs in every match. I have scored 40 runs in every match. So this mean is just a representative. mean is just a representative. You cannot list out all the 25 numbers. So you're finding a representative for all the 25 numbers. You're finding one number that can represent all the 25 numbers. What is it? Tell me. You are finding. When you find mean, what are you trying to find? You're finding one number.
One.
Just tell me what I repeat what I just said. I said when we find mean, we are finding one number that can represent all the 25 numbers. If we have 25 scores, when we find mean, we are finding one number that can represent all the 25 numbers. Repeat.
When we find one mean, it tells about all the 25 numbers.
It represents.
Okay.
Mean becomes representative. It represents all the 25 numbers. See the answer? Answer, you know. You just have to add all the scores. So here we have 6 scores. So its total runs will be 36 plus 35 plus 50 plus 46 plus 60 plus 55. Add all the scores. See, this is not a fixed formula. Now you can write, this is a general formula. You can write this for everything. You can write this one for you can write this for everything. Mean is equal to sum of all observations by number of observations. We know this is the standard formula. Mean is equal to sum of all observations by number of observations. For the earlier one also, you can write the same thing. This is written specific to this situation. This is written specific to this situation. You can also write mean is equal to, or you can write average study time is equal to sum of all the observations by number of observations. It's the same thing. You will add the three numbers and divide by 3. That's a standard formula. You know it by now. Mean is equal to, or average is equal to, sum of all the observations by number of observations. This you can write for every situation. To find mean, you can write this formula. This one is specific to this situation. In this particular situation, you can say total number of study hours by the number of days for which he studied. He studied for 3 days. Number of days for which he studied, 3 days. This is the same formula. Mean is equal to sum of all observations by number of observations. This formula we've written according to the situation, that's all. Take a screenshot, children. So when you find mean, you get 47. So this 47 represents all the 6 numbers. This number 47 represents all the 6 numbers. So he can say, if he does not want to say all the 6 scores, he can say, okay, on an average, I've got 47 runs in every match. On an average, I have got 47 runs in every match. So that 47 represents all the 6 numbers, which is the mean. Took a picture, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now see, in example 3, the ages and years of 10 teachers of a school are. These are the ages of 10 teachers. So one teacher is 32 years old. There is a teacher who's 41 years old. There is a teacher who's 28 years old. There's a teacher who's 54 years old, and so on. These are the ages in years of 10 teachers in a school. 10 teachers. Some school, 10 teachers. Ages of 10 teachers. What's the question? What is the age of the oldest teacher? and that of the youngest teacher. So what's the age of the oldest teacher?
Ma'am, it's 54. 54. Yeah.
54. And the youngest teacher?
23.
Okay. 54 is the age of the eldest teacher. 23 is the age of the youngest teacher. What is the range of the ages of the teachers? This is how we find the range.
Yes,
range is the highest observation minus lowest observation. Now the highest observation you said is 54.
Sure.
Lowest observation 23. 53 minus 23 is the range of the data. You know, this is a raw data. These numbers are called data or raw data. Somebody's mic is enabled. Please disable your mic. So these numbers are called raw data. Data, D-A-T-A, data, raw data. Now we found the oldest teacher is 54. The youngest teacher is 23. So the range is 54 minus 23. Range is equal to highest observation minus lowest observation. In the data, whichever is the highest value minus the lowest value will give you the range. Supposing you go to a textile shop. There he shows one sari for say 200 rupees, and then there's another sari for 20,000 rupees. We'll just say that. Okay, so we are in a sari shop now, a textile shop. We've gone there to get a sari. There is a sari which costs rupees 200. There is another sari in that shop. The highest price of a sari in that shop is 20,000. So what is the range? If you ask the shopkeeper, show me a sari which is very cheap in your shop. He shows the sari which is priced 200 rupees. Then you ask the shopkeeper, okay, now show me a sari which is the costliest, the most costly in your shop. So he gets one sari and he says, this is the highest price. This is 20,000. Now what is the range in the price of the sari?
Ma'am, we should minus highest observation by lowest observation, ma'am.
Yes,
so that means it's 20,000 minus 200.
Yes, what is 20,000 minus 200?
The range, ma'am.
That's what's the answer? What is 20,000 minus 200? Class, what's the answer?
Ma'am, money with my calculator and tell, ma'am.
Yeah, where are the others? Anugraha, Matthew, Nandana. Nandana is here, okay.
Matthew, Anugraha.
Yeah, okay. Swati is not joined today, I think. Deepchika, are you there?
Mom, can I say?
Yes, Matthew.
1,800.
Louder, Matthew.
1,800.
No, 20,000 minus 200 is not 1,800.
Ma'am, 19,800.
19,800. 20,000 minus 200 is 19,800. Deepchika, are you there? All right. So this is what is the range, the highest value minus the lowest value. And then you know how to find the mean age of the teachers. So there are three questions here. Oldest teacher, youngest teacher. Then you should find the range of the ages of the teachers. And then you need to find the mean. Take a screenshot, children, to see the answer column. See the answer column. This is the solution column. This is the question. This is this question which we just saw. This is the answer. Please see the answer. Take a picture. Oldest teacher, youngest teacher, then range. Then mean age will be, you should add all the ages and divide by 10, because there are 10 teachers, right? So you should divide by 10. So on an average, the age of every teacher is 35 years. On an average, the age of every teacher is 35 years.
Took a screenshot, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, I can see Deepshika, I can see Matthew, Nandana, Mritika, and Anugraha. Chidan, any doubts?
No, ma'am.
No doubt, ma'am.
Okay. So here, find the range of heights of any 10 students of your class. So just take, simply give some numbers, make it, let the numbers be between 130 and 160. Because normally, you people are about 12 years old. You cannot see height. You don't take 10 centimeter, 20 centimeter. Human beings are not that short, 10 and 20 centimeters, which is about the size of a scale. Okay, so let the numbers be somewhere between 130 and 160. It can be a little more than 160 also, but for the 7th standard, I'm telling you, 130, or you can say 140 to 160. Make sure that you take heights in this range. So find the range of height of any 10 students of your class. So this is the question. The height is not given. The heights of the 10 students not given. So you can just assume some heights. So let the heights of 10 students in the class be, I told you, take 10 different numbers. From 140 to 160 or 130 to 160. So I've just taken randomly 150, 152, 151. Randomly I've taken the numbers. Take any 10 numbers. Heights here measured in centimeter. Take any 10 numbers between 140 and 160. Okay, so find the height, find the range of the heights. So you can arrange the heights in the ascending order, because sometimes it becomes difficult to make out which is the highest, which is the lowest. So you can arrange it in the ascending order. You can arrange the numbers in the ascending order. So after arranging the ascending order, the range height of the students is equal to the highest value, 153, minus the lowest value, 147, which is 6. Range is equal to highest value minus the lowest value. 153 minus 147, which is 6. So the range of the height of students is 6. Is that fine, children? We just have to find the range here, not mean, only range.
Okay, ma'am.
Take a picture, children.
A picture, ma'am.
Yeah. So here the question is, organize the following marks in a class assessment in a tabular form. Organize the following marks, meaning you should arrange it. Okay, so organize the following marks in a class assessment. So what you see are the marks obtained by students in a class assessment. Those numbers which you see there, those numbers that you see there are the marks obtained by students in a class assessment, in a class test. They wanted to organize these marks in a tabular form and then answer the questions. See, organize. You need to organize. First, organize it in the form of a table, and then you should answer these questions. Is that fine? Is the question understood?
Yes, ma'am.
You need to put this in the form of a table and then answer these questions. So see here, you've seen this earlier. These are the marks. These are the marks, children. So you have marks from 1 to 9. You can write scores here, marks, grades, whatever. The heading is, you can write marks, you can write score, grades, tally marks, frequency. So you're aware of this. So marks, tally marks, frequencies. Now, what are the marks here? There's one, there is two, there is three, there is four, there is five, there is six, there is seven, there is eight, there is nine. But all are single digit numbers. You don't find two digit numbers at all. You don't find two digit numbers. All are single digit numbers. And there is no zero also. There is no zero also. There is no zero here. And there are no two digit numbers. So numbers are only from 1 to 9. So marks only from 1 to 9. That's the first column. Then how many ones are there? Only one, one. So here tally mark, one. How many twos? One, two twos. So two tally marks. How many threes? How many threes? One. That's all, only one three. So only one tally mark. So count the number of fours. You'll get four, three fours. And how many fives? Five fives. So see here, one, two, three, four, and five. Five fives. And you know, this is how we represent five. One, two, three, four, and we slash it to show five. This bundle is five. This bundle is five. This bundle is five. One, two, three, four, and when you slash it, this bundle is a five. So like that, write out all the observations you see, 1 to 9. You have numbers only from 1 to 9 here. Supposing there was 5 and 6 were not there, you should not write 5 and 6. Supposing nobody had scored 5 or 6, then don't show 5 and 6. It's not that you should write all the numbers from 1 to 9. You must write only the numbers you find here. You should write only the numbers found here, not numbers from 1 to 9. So supposing nobody had scored 4 mark, and 4 marks, and nobody had scored 7 marks, then this 4 and 7 will not come. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 8, 9. 4 and 7 you should not write. So after writing the marks, show the tally marks like this. And frequencies, what you write from the tally marks. 1, here 2, here 1, this is 3, this is 5. This is 4, this is 2, 1 and 1. And then you know the formula to find mean. In the case of a table, you know how to find mean. Mean is equal to, see here, the formula, total of the FIXI column by the total of the FI column. So you, marks represent the XI column. Marks represent the XI column. Frequency represents FI column. Frequency represents FI column. Marks, XI column. Marks, XI column. Now you should create a new column called the FIXI. You should create a new column called the FIXI column. Swati, you joined us late, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Deepshika, can you hear us? Can you hear me?
Sorry for the late, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Once again, Deepika, you can hear us?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Matthew, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Mrithika? Mrithika, are you there? Anugraha?
I'm here.
Okay. So children, marks, the first column is marks, the second column tally marks. Tally marks is simply to count how many ones are there, one. So just put one.
How many times it's repeating?
Yeah, how many times a particular number repeats. Now three happens once, so only one tally mark. But five happens five times. You can see five times here. So you should write, you should show five tally marks. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4. And to show 5, slash the 4 tally marks. So this bundle is 5. After using the tally marks, use the tally marks to write the frequency. Use the tally marks to write the frequency. 1, 2, 1, 3, 5, 4, 2, 1, and 1. After, so all this, all the first three columns, the first three columns you prepare by using the data given. The first three columns you prepare using the data given. Now you need to prepare one extra column, FI, XI.
And we have to multiply the X column with the F column, ma'am.
Correct. So XI, FI. So now this is the FI, XI column. So this is the FI value, the corresponding XI value. One second, children.
Ma'am, doubt, ma'am.
Yes, Matthew.
Ma'am, we don't need to put tally marks for the grades.
We have put tally marks. It's not a compulsory column. You can directly write the frequencies. But we have shown.
Ma'am, we are writing tally mark for frequency, ma'am.
No, frequency is for the grades only, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Frequency itself is for the grades only.
Yes, ma'am.
Tally marks is for the grades. Frequency is also for the grade only. For five, the frequency is 5. The frequency itself is for the grades.
Yes, ma'am.
So now how do we prepare the FI XI column? FI XI? FI into XI. One into,
yes, ma'am.
One. Then this FI, the second FI. Two into two, four. Then tell me.
And three into one, two, three.
And
three.
Four into three.
Four into three, 12. Five into five, 25. Six into four, 24. Seven twos are 14. Eight ones are 8. Nine ones are 9.
Yeah. So we should, to find the values in the FI XI column, you need to multiply the FI value with the corresponding XI value. 1 into 1, 1. Now, for example, 4 into 6, the FI value with the corresponding XI value. 4 into 6, 24. 2 into 7, 14. So like that, you should prepare the, you should get the values in the FI XI column. Then you should add sigma FI XI means the total of the FI XI column. Sigma FI XI, the symbol stands for sigma or summation, total of. The symbol is pronounced sigma, which means total of. So total of the FI XI column, you should add all these numbers. Add all these numbers, we get 100. By the total of the FI column, add all these numbers. The symbol stands for total of the FI XI column. This is the FI XI column. Sigma FI XI, total it up. So when you add these marks, it is 100. When you add all this, you get 20. Now mean is equal to sigma fi xi by sigma fi, 100 by 20, which is 5. So other questions can answer. Yeah,
one second. I have a doubt, ma'am.
Yeah, please.
Ma'am, what is arithmetic mean, ma'am?
Yeah, yeah, it's the same as mean. Arithmetic mean, yeah.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, it's like an average.
It's an average, yes. No, arithmetic because it deals with numbers. Arithmetic. We say algebra, arithmetic, geometry, right?
When it's yes, algebra, ma'am. Yeah, yes, ma'am. Algebra, we will say algebraic mean, ma'am.
Yeah, so when it's algebra, we use variables, x, y, z, and all that. In geometry, it's about figures. Arithmetic is about numbers. So since the value of mean is a number, we say arithmetic mean. Mean, arithmetic mean are the same. It's a numerical value, so we say arithmetic mean. The other questions, you know, highest grade, lowest grade, and the range. Range is the highest value minus the lowest value. 9 minus.
Ma'am, the difference between the highest grade and the lowest grade, ma'am.
Yeah. Take a picture, children.
Took a picture, ma'am.
Took a picture, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, I have a doubt, ma'am.
Yeah?
Ma'am, since I have joined late, I don't know whether you discussed the answers for the homework question, ma'am. Whether you discussed or not, ma'am.
No, but we discussed the homework questions in the last period.
Ma'am, the homework which you gave last class, you told to complete it in the today's class, no, ma'am?
Okay, let me just finish and come back to that. No, you would have taken the screenshots, no, of the answers?
Yes,
no?
Ma'am. Ma'am, no, ma'am, that question you gave it as a test on last class. You gave us the tabular column and you told to complete that, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. It's 15th question, ma'am.
Oh, let me open that PPT. Okay. I'll open the PPT in some time. Just tell me where.
Okay, yes, ma'am.
Yeah, okay. Is this over?
Yes, ma'am. Took a screenshot, ma'am. We can move.
Yes, ma'am.
This is similar, children. Take a picture.
Took a screenshot, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, since it's a whole number, we need to add 0, no, ma'am?
Yes, yes. First five ma'am, whole numbers.
Yes, ma'am, if they ask natural number, we can write it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, no, ma'am?
Five. Yes. First five natural numbers, then you must write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. First five whole numbers. So 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4 are the first five numbers. Yes. Any other questions on this?
No, ma'am, no doubts.
Yes, ma'am, no doubts.
All right. Yeah, read the question. See the table. Read all the questions and we'll discuss the answer. Read the question, children. I'll just get back. Give me a minute. Understood what information is given, children?
Yes, ma'am. Understood, ma'am.
Okay. How many players are there?
Ma'am, there are totally 3 players in a game, ma'am.
Okay, what are they called? The 3 players?
Ma'am, player A, player B, and player C, ma'am.
C.
Okay. How many games has player A played?
Ma'am, all the games until 4 years.
All the games.
Okay, so all the three players have played 4 games. But C did not play the third game. C did not play the third game. Understood the question, children?
Yes, ma'am. Understood the question.
Yes, ma'am. Understood the questions.
So now it's all about finding
the mean, ma'am.
Yeah. Sorry. Yeah. Yes, children. Now let's answer the questions. Find the mean to determine A's average number of points. A's average number of points scored per game. Find the mean. You have to find the mean. That's all. Find the mean.
Find the mean of A player A.
Yeah, we need to find the mean of the points scored by player A.
And for that, we have to add what her score in game 1, game 2, game 3 and game 4. And then we have to divide it by 4, ma'am. Sum up the total points and then divide it by 4.
So it'll be 14. Tell me, it'll be 14 plus?
16 plus 10 plus 10 divided by 4, ma'am.
Okay, we'll simplify that later. That's what it is for the first one. The second one, to find the mean number of points per game for C. To find the mean number of points per game for C, would not, okay, we would divide, there's a mistake there. It should be like, we need to divide the total points by 3 or by 4?
Because he played only three games.
One by one, let me ask somebody, one by one, 1 minute. Now the question, let me clarify the question. To find the mean number of points per game for C. So for C, look at C. Okay, so C did not play one game. He did not play game 3. So they're asking you this question for C. For C, they're asking you, when you find the mean for C, will you divide the total points by 3 or by 4? That is the question. 1 minute, I haven't finished. Let me tell you again. There is a mistake here in printing. When you're finding the mean points for C, will you divide by 3 or by 4? Will you divide the total number of points by 3 or by 4? That's the question.
By 3, ma'am.
By 3 or by 4?
I'm by 3.
I'm 3, ma'am.
So now let's say, now you have you study six subjects in your school, okay? You study six subjects in your school. Now, so say the subjects are English, Hindi, Tamil, social studies, science and maths. Now say you did not, you could for some reason, some family event or some reason you could not take up one exam. You did not write, say, the English exam. So of the six exams or of the six tests, you wrote only 5. 6 tests were conducted. You wrote only 5. You could not take up the English test for some reason. You couldn't go to school that day, so you did not write this test. It's not online. Offline, we are talking about the normal situations. So when you go to school, so you did not write. Now, say that in your report card, the teacher will always give the average marks per subject. For every test, say she'll calculate the average marks. So what she'll do for you, she'll add the marks scored by you in 5 subjects. She has to calculate the average marks scored by you per subject. So she'll add the marks in the 5 subjects. Whatever you've scored in the 5 subjects, she'll add those marks and she'll divide by 6. She'll not divide by 5. It's our mistake. We did not take up. So she'll give 0 or you'll be marked absent.
Ma'am, the exam that we don't and consider as zero, ma'am.
Yeah, okay, that's what it differs in different schools. Either it is absent or zero, whatever. So it's like it's our mistake. The game was conducted, you did not participate. So the exam was conducted, you did not write it. So for that, she cannot divide by six exams. So she will divide for all the students, she will divide by six. Because the teacher has conducted six exams. Whether the child has written six or no, she will divide the total score by six. In the same way, so she'll add all your marks. She'll add the marks in five subjects, divided by six. So in that particular test, you know, your average marks per subject will be low because you did not write one test, right? So your average, you may be a very good student, but since you didn't write one test, your average mark will be low. Your average mark will be low because one subject you did not write, but she's dividing by six. So your average will be less. When compared to you had written the test. If you had written the test, then your average would have been a little more. So now tell me, will you divide the total points by three or by four?
Ma'am, because if you did not play, it does not matter, ma'am. We can consider it as zero.
Yeah,
yes, ma'am.
Not play. It's like I did not write the test. The teacher will not say, okay, you didn't write the test, then I'll divide by five. No. Average is, she's conducted six tests. So she'll divide by six. So here it will be divided by four. Okay. Yeah, the rest is easy. See you.
Ma'am, for the D1A is the best performer, ma'am.
Very good, very good. Yes, children, now read every question, see the answer, and see if you have any doubts. Deepshika?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, Deepshika, you are in the middle of this chapter, actually.
Yes, ma'am.
But are you trying to, are you able to follow something?
Yes, ma'am, I understand, ma'am.
Okay. Because we are almost going to finish this chapter.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so please make sure that you write all this in your notebook before the next class. The next class will be on Friday morning.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, so before the next class, make sure that you have written all this in your notebook, your maths tuition notebook, all right?
Ma'am, we have taken the screenshot somehow, ma'am.
Yeah.
Okay, ma'am.
No, whatever screenshot you have with you, use that and write it in your notebook. Complete that in your notebook, All right.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, you must write the question and then and then work the answer. Not okay. Only the answer. You should write the question and the answer.
Okay, ma'am.
All right. So children, so whenever we will have to find average, A's average. See, find the mean to determine A's average. Find the mean. They have given you all. They have also given you that. Find the mean to determine A's average. So A's average. A's average is equal to add all this scores divide by 4 because 4 matches or 4 games 1 2 3 4 games add the 4 numbers and divide by 4 add the 4 numbers and divide by 4 then next we need to find C's average so C's average will be add all this He 8 plus 11 plus 0 plus 13 divided by 4. So for A, B and C, what you understand is A, B and C, whether they have played, their 4 games have been conducted. For A, B and C, 4 games have been conducted. Whether they have taken up all the 4 games or not, their average will be calculated by dividing by 4 only. For everybody, the average will be calculated by dividing the sum by 4. Four games have been conducted. Three players, 4 games. So for every player to find the mean, the total score or the total points will be divided by 4 only. They have conducted, the teacher has conducted 6 tests. I did not attend 1 test. So that's like my mistake. She will add my marks and divide by 6 only, not by 5, because she has conducted 6 tests. I missed 1 test. Now she has to compare the average for all the students, right? So in a class, if there are 30 students, she'll find the average marks for every student and she has to compare. How can she compare if she divides my total by 5, somebody else's total by 4, somebody else's total by 6, then how can you compare? You cannot compare. You can compare the average marks. You can compare the average marks of different students only when you divide everyone's total by 6. There should be some uniformity in calculation. Only then you can compare. So for the sake of comparing, you have to divide everyone's marks. The marks of all the students, the total marks of all the students always by 6. If a student has not written 2 exams, still add the 4 marks and divide by 6. So here also, this is C's average. So since we are comparing the performance, so we divide by 4 to find the mean for C. Okay, we have to compare. We are comparing the performances of A, B and C. So we need to divide by 4 to find the mean for C. I have just calculated the mean. You don't have to find the mean. They have not asked you to find. The question is to find the mean. Should you divide by 3 or 4 and why? So actually you don't have to find the mean. I have just found the mean. That's all.
Ma'am, for the comparison in the D question, we can find the average, ma'am. It's easier to find.
Later when it's asked, at this point, it's not required. That's what I'm trying to say. At this point, it's not asked. I'm just trying to clarify that. Because you may think that mean is not asked why she's calculated. They've just asked whether you should divide by 3 or by 4. So your answer is you should divide by 4 because we are comparing the performances. 3 or 4, 4. Why? Because we're comparing the performances. So when you're comparing the performance, when you're comparing, you should, you must do the same thing for everybody. You must divide for everybody's total, you should divide by 4. There should be uniformity. Then in C, B played in all the 4 games. How do you find the mean? So you know that he played all the 4 games. But in game 1, he did not score anything. So by 4, this you understand. Add his scores and divide by 4. Then since they've asked you, how would you find the mean? we played in all the four games, how would you find the mean? So to find B's mean or B's average, we find the sum of all the observations and divide this by the number of observations. This is all in your own words, children. You can just write to find B's average. We find the total of his points. We add all the scores, or we add all the points scored by B and divide by 4. Just write it in your own words. We add all the points scored by B and divide by 4. Just express what you're doing, that's all. Now, in the last one, we have who's the best performer? Who is the best performer? So, whose mean is more? A's mean is more. A's mean is more than C's.
And B's mean.
So since A's mean is more, the best performer is A. So because this question is asked, because this question was asked, who's the best performer? That means we have to find the mean for A, B, and C. That's why then and there I found it. Otherwise, you'll have to work everything in D. So since this question was there, who's the best performer? Even if mean was not asked, I worked mean there. So that you can just directly answer the last question.
Ma'am, I have a doubt, ma'am.
Yeah?
Ma'am, in the D question, they have asked the best performer, no, ma'am. And right. They haven't told us for doing the mean, no, ma'am. So if they didn't ask, can we sum up the total points which is scored by each game and then see who scored the greater one?
That also will give you the same result, but to find who's the best performer, you'll have to always find the average. You should compare the average. Compare the average, not the total scores. It will be the same.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. You have to find the average. To find the best performer, you should not sum up the total points, you must find the average.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So see again, first we have to find the mean for A. Mean for A, so add all the points scored by A and divide by 4. Then we have to, for C, we have to answer this question. If you should divide by 3 or by 4. If he did not play one match, that doesn't mean that this will be ignored. For everybody, for the sake of uniformity, for everybody, you should divide by 4, the total points by 4. So the reason is, since we are comparing the performances, we need to divide by 4 to find the mean for C. And there I found the mean also. For C, I also found the mean. Add scores, divide by 4, 8. And then for B, for this option C, B played in all the four games. How would you find the mean? How do you find the mean? You should find the total of all his points and divide by 4. That's what is here. Who is the best performer? So comparing the means, 12.5, 8 and 4.5. You can just write, A's average is the highest. So you see, again, it's your style. It's not that these two steps are the answer. You can just say that A's average score or A's average points is the highest. So he's the best performer. So A is the best performer. Who's the best performer? A is the best performer because his average score per game is the highest. His average score per game is the highest. Or is average points per game is the highest. Take a picture, children.
took a picture, ma'am.
Yeah, take a screenshot of the question. Work this as homework.
Yes, ma'am, took a screenshot.
Yeah, this is homework. This one also homework.
Took screenshot, ma'am.
Okay. Yeah, this also homework.
Yes, ma'am, done.
Right. Yeah, this one homework, take a picture.
Ma'am, this is the solution for the homework which you gave, ma'am.
No. These are only questions. What you've been taking screenshots now are only questions.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, please. I'm showing you from behind again. I'll show you the questions from behind again. Done, children?
Done,
yes, ma'am. Completed, ma'am.
Now we can move, ma'am.
Yeah, this is the second question.
Took screenshot, ma'am.
All right. Third question.
Yes, ma'am. Took a screenshot.
Done, ma'am. Took, ma'am.
The fourth question.
Yes, ma'am. Took screenshot.
Yes, ma'am.
We can move further, ma'am.
Now you are talking about the earlier one, right?
Yes, ma'am.
One. Let me open that. I'll just unshare my screen. I'll open that file.
Okay, yes, ma'am.
See you, children. Are these the questions?
Yes, yes, ma'am. This is the question,
ma'am.
Ma'am, shall I answer for this?
Yeah, 1 minute, yes. How many questions, children?
Ma'am, totally this only the question which you gave for homework.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, this only the question. Only this one?
Yes, ma'am. Only this one, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
I'll just unshare my screen so that I can see the answer. Okay, I'll ask. Ma'am. Yeah, 1 minute. You can't see my screen, right?
Yes, ma'am.
No, ma'am. Okay. It's unshared.
Okay. Now, Nandana, what is the first FIXI value?
Ma'am, first FIXI value is 1,485.
Okay. Swati, what's the second FIXI value?
Ma'am, the second FIXI value is 175 into 8, ma'am, which is 1,400.
175, no, it is 170.
Sorry, ma'am, 170 I told for the second one, ma'am. Ma'am, it's 1,360, ma'am.
1,360. Anugraha?
Yes.
What's the third FIXI value, Anugraha? The third one? Matthew? Okay, then Swati, back to Swati. Swati, what's the third FIXI value?
Ma'am, 175 into 11, 1925, ma'am.
Nandana, what's the fourth FIXI value?
Ma'am, 180 into 12, which is 8,460, ma'am.
No, darling.
Ma'am, 2,160, ma'am.
2,160. So I think you would have got the answer incorrect. No problem. What's the total of the FIXI column? Anybody can answer. What's it? Now, I think Nandana would have got it incorrect because her last FIXI value is not right. Okay, so what's the total? Swati, what's the total of the FIXI column? I'm not audible. Deepshika, can you hear me?
Ma'am, shall I say? Now yeah. You got connection. Ma'am, it's like 1,485 plus 1,360 plus 1,925 and then 2,160, ma'am, which is equal to 6,930.
Okay. Correct. Nandana, what's the total of the FI column?
Ma'am, the answer is 40, ma'am.
40.
Yes, ma'am, 40.
Yeah, what's the mean? I think Nandana wouldn't have got it right because your total is incorrect. So what is the mean, Swati?
Ma'am, the mean is 690 divided by 40, which is
17.25. 17.25, huh?
Yes, ma'am.
Just have a look at the answer. I'm just coming back.
Take a screenshot, ma'am.
Yeah, so please do the corrections. Mean is 6,930 by 40. The zeros will get cancelled, correct? How do you simplify? You can cancel the 0 and 0. You can cancel the 0 and 0. So you'll get 693 by 4. Cancelling the 0 and 0, you get 693 by 4. Now, you can do the long division like this. See, I've shown the long division here. You can divide 693 by 4 like this here. 693 by 4. Can you see the long division?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah,
yes,
you can do the long division and get the answer 173.25. Or we know another method. The denominator is 4. So you can multiply and divide by 25. You can multiply the numerator by 25, denominator by 25. And that will give you 17,325 by 100. And now using the concept of decimals, you can divide. How do you divide by 100? Just place a decimal point. After the decimal point, there should be two digits. So 173.25 centimeters. After 693 by 4 children, you can do the long division like this and get the answer 173.25. Or 4 into 25 is 100. 4 into 25 is 100. You cannot bring 4 to 10. You cannot bring 4 to 10. So we'll bring 4 to 100 by multiplying the denominator by 25 and numerator also by 25. Because you'll have to multiply the denominator by 25, you should do the same thing in the numerator. So that gives you 17,325 by 100. Two zeros. So place a decimal point so that you have two digits after the decimal point. two zeros or two digits after the decimal point. So see a decimal point, after that we have two digits, 25. So 173.25. So you can work it anyways. You can complete the calculation anyways, like this.
Ma'am, we can also directly multiply it, directly divide it.
That's what, ma'am. See here, we directly divide 6930 by 40, is it?
Ma'am, after canceling the zeros, ma'am.
See, you can also divide 6930 by 40 straight away. You will get, however you do, you will get the same answer. You can also divide 6930 by 40 straight away. You will get the same answer. Or you can cancel the zeros and then divide. Or you can use this method. All right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
And the mistakes I have found here for the mean to be wrong is that I did not add the zeros, ma'am, so I got that answer.
Ma'am, here also I put the number as opposite, ma'am. Secondly, I multiplied with 1, ma'am. I should get as 1800, ma'am. But I got as 81 by 100, ma'am. I did a mistake, ma'am.
Yeah. Next time we have to be careful. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. All right, children. Take a screenshot of this and do the corrections. So that's it for today's session, children. Thank you so much. You may leave the meeting.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, children. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.